Well, gang, I figured why not? I mean, hell. After watching a video of a GE alarm clock TV radio thing that Emerson Collie has, I figured I'd show this off that I picked up at the Goodwill shop one first Saturday of the month. I think it was a month or two ago. I can't remember, but yeah. This being a Quasar 4.5-inch, 5-inch, black and white alarm clock TV radio thing. It's supposed to have a phone receiver. I'll explain that in a minute. And with this being a model number, I'm trying to do this one-handed while holding the camera. My hand's cramping up. Chassis service number. Manufactured November 1985 for 1986. It's model number AP1495YH. 120 volts, 60 hertz, 11 watts. Quasar Company of Franklin Park, Illinois. Division of Matsushita Electric Corporation. Sadly, made in Taiwan. Once again, do not open or you will die. But yeah. This was an interesting story. I mean, I saw this, and I was gonna... I mean, $7 was a decent price for it. But I kind of was hesitant because, well, at first it looked kind of funny looking. Almost like a little mini computer, all-in-one computer thing. But when I noticed it had missing the receiver, I really was like, oh, I don't know. I really don't need it. And, yeah, probably I could find a receiver on eBay, but I don't know if I actually want to actually use it as a phone or just maybe jury-rig this for something. For if, like, somebody's knocking at my door, I can look at the camera and look at this and see. I don't know. Yeah. And, yeah. That time is correct, so we're going to turn on the radio first.
Slid the line to the right side, so you look at...
Let me extend the antenna so I can get some better FM stereo. Well, this isn't FM stereo, but yeah.
DGB's running the stick route. He's
got... Oh, shut up! Shut up!
Amendola.
Oh, God damn, how many of these...
$99 a month. It's so easy at Genesis. Come in now, get...
You gotta go get it, go get it. They hating, they thinking, they waiting.
Titans three-man defensive front.
Are you fucking serious? Three stations showing the damn stupid loser tour? I mean, really? Loser tour! We don't need them!
In the second...
Check it out.
Apparently, a few stations will be playing all Christmas music until Christmas, so...
Not be, you know, yeah. Good to have them.
And Nigella, great to have you back with us.
Let's try AM. Doubt I'm going
to
find anything.
More and more of these bags that
and best prices. Call.
Yeah, whatever. We'll turn on TV and yeah, but sadly, since there's no more analog or whatever there is, it's so low. Probably the interference from the light bulb. Well, I'll turn that off for a moment and we'll hook up this VCR right here. Yeah, it's another VCR. Woohoo. But this one I bought at the city thrift yesterday for $5 because, well, it's a Panasonic 4-head hi-fi stereo Omnivision. And it's the wide body, probably so you can set it on top of your stereo amp. And what was amazing, because the fact it came with the manuals and the remote. So, very cool. And it's a model number. Whoops, did I turn the light off? There we go. PV V4601. Come on, focus. Yeah, PV V4601. Manufactured 20th of October 2001 for a 2K2 model. Sadly, in Indonesia. But no China Pride crap here. So, yeah. And I have the cable with the little connector thingy. So, yeah. To hook up these little TVs. So, what I'll do, I'll hook it up and we'll give it a go. Alright, I'll turn the TV back on. God damn it! I hate these switches. And what I'll do, I'll turn the VCR on. It's supposed to get like a blue screen or something. I probably hooked something up wrong. Hold that thought. Well, I think the problem is, the external antenna jack might be messed up because I try and it's not getting a signal. So, but yet when I have the wire touching the antenna directly, I get it, although it's not very perfect. So, let's just say a quick jury rig version of this. So,
and now our feature presentation.
Well, you gotta believe me. The TV will work. I'm probably gonna have to fix that internal jack or whatever, so yeah. So yeah. Wish the show and tell was a little bit better, but you know what? We can't get everything. So I guess I'm gonna conclude this video of the Quasar TV clock radio, supposed to have a phone receiver, model number escapes me at the moment, and a quick, well not really a quick overview, just the fact that this $5 Panasonic PVV 4601 4-head hi-fi Omnivision, it works, so yeah. So I guess, until next time, whatever it is, I'm Eskie, thank you for watching, and the comment box is open. Okay, once again, more to this episode. I mean, if you notice, the screen is blank, but also, I was able to get the connector to work. So it wasn't the jack, it's the input jack itself. It was this adapter, which I think may be faulty. So maybe it's a good thing I got a pack of 8 of them. I don't know. But yeah. That's it.